वी लिव इन अ वर्ल्ड ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स एंड येट द वर्ल्ड गोज ऑन अनडाउटेडली बिकॉज ऑफ द कोऑपरेशन ऑफ नेशंस एंड ऑपरेशन एंड देयर इज टूडे अ वास्ट अमाउंट ऑफ कोऑपरेशन इवन बिटवीन कंट्रीज विच आर opposed to each other in the political or other fields. Little is known or said about this cooperation that is going on, but a great deal is said about every point of conflict, and therefore the world is full of the idea that we live on the verge of disaster. It would perhaps be a truer picture if the cooperating elements in the world were put forward and we were made to think that the world depended on cooperation and not on conflict. A proposal has been made by many persons to the effect that more attention should be directed to the cooperative ventures, especially for peace and in the interest of peace, so that more positive thinking may take place on this subject and people may realize that this cooperation is already taking place and can be extended. Some years ago, it was resolved to have an international geophysical year. That was a specific subject. However, it has been suggested that perhaps this assembly might resolve to call upon all countries of the world to devote a year to the furtherance of cooperative activities in political, cultural, and the many other fields, not to mere speeches about peace that perhaps will direct some of our energy and some of our thinking to this idea of cooperation, which will create an atmosphere helpful for solving the problems more easily, that by itself will not solve any problem, but it will lessen this distrust and conflict which affect the world. I make this suggestion to you not in any detail but broadly, so that this assembly might consider it, and if it is worthwhile, perhaps appoint a committee to consider it further and make suggestions as to how this might perhaps be done. The great men of the world have been those who have fought hatred and violence, and not those who have encouraged it. We have arrived at the stage when even in some worthwhile cause, hatred and violence have to be checked. This requires a new way of thinking, a new development of humanity. Possibly we are going through that process, and this very crisis will wake up the mind of man and direct it to this new way of thinking. What shall it profit the world if it conquers the material ills and then commits suicide because it has not controlled its own mind? Para.
Subscribe the channel for regular shorthand and stenography videos.